Hi, this is a Minute of Overpass. My name is Eric and I make apps. Now this week I want to talk about how to learn how to develop apps. Okay, so after last week's video, I got a comment from somebody called iClash, Clash of Clans and More, which is great use of keywords in your name, by the way. And what he said was he wants to learn how to develop apps. And I kind of said, well, what you should do is put something out quickly. Don't spend a lot of time developing it. Get it onto the App Store, which was the topic of last week's video. And he came back saying, no, that's not it. I'm an absolute beginner. I want to know how to develop apps. So this is basically meant for iClash or anybody else out there who wants to develop their own apps or their own games and want to know where to get started. Now, there are tools out there where you could use to make apps without learning any code at all. Like there's, if you're going to do a game, there's one called Game Salad, which is actually pretty advanced. You could drag things onto a 2D interface and set triggers and stuff, a little bit like Scratch if you use that before. A lot of kids use that. And if you do things like business applications, there's one out there called AppyPie. There's one called Good Barber. We're kind of working on something that's in the works at the moment. So there are ways of making an app without learning to code. However, think of it like using sentences. Like if you were going to learn, say, Italian, if you don't know Italian, and you were going to learn a bunch of phrases. Now, those phrases will help you converse and will help you get by in Italy, but they won't teach you how to make sentences. Now, what you would have to do is deconstruct those phrases and make into their individual parts. And that's all that code is. Now, when I moved to England back 18 years ago, I had no coding experience. I had just got my degree from university and it was in history. So somehow I got a job out here as in a computer job. And I like to talk about the time I checked a book out from the library. It is the book that's had the biggest, most profound impact on my life so far, and it's called Visual Basic 5 in 21 Days, right? Now, I read this book, and not in 21 days, it took me a lot longer, but that book has made me hundreds of thousands of pounds in the years since, because that was the point where I realized that I could learn something and learn how to code something. So you have to understand, I was working in a place where everybody had computer graduate degrees, and I kind of thought, well, that's something for somebody else, right? And learning to code is actually not as hard as you might think. Now, I can't really go too much into it in such a short video here, but one thing you need to understand is that you're going to be bad at it at first, right? So learning how to do some very basic coding, you're going to make mistakes and you're going to think that it's not for you. But the truth is, the people who design these languages, however misguided they might be, actually kind of hope that most people will be able to understand it. So, when you're learning a language, it's not meant for you. It's kind of meant for everybody. It's like very fine level descriptions. It's like I said, you take a phrase, you take it apart, you get the sentences, you get the grammar. It's learning that grammar, right? And it's not meant for people. I mean, binary is not meant for people. Code is meant for people. So, in terms of what kind of languages you should learn. Now, if you're looking into games, I still like Corona SDK, and that's based on Lua. It's a very easy language to learn. It's not very portable, so you might not get a job with it if that's what you're looking to do, but you can develop an app, and you can do a really nice game. If you're learning, if you go into JavaScript, which is for some reason has just become the language lately, you could do lots of business applications, you could do server programming, you could do all kinds of things. I mean, if I was going to talk to a new developer just coming up, I would say go into JavaScript. I went into the Visual Basic, C#, all the Microsoft stack, but right now, JavaScript's the big thing. Or if you're just considered interested in games, you could also do Objective-C, although I think that's, in my experience, that's a lot more difficult. But then you could do something like Cocos 2DX, and there's a JavaScript version as well. But that would help you create games for both Android and iPhone as well. But Corona SDK, if you learn Lua, which I tell you is a very easy language to learn, you can start coding games right away. It used to cost like £600 $600 a year. Now it costs, now it's free to be able to put games out. So anyway, iClash, thank you very much for commenting on the video. Don't worry, you can do a game. I mean, you can make an app or a game. If you use something like GameSolid, you can get it out there right away. If you learn just some very basic find some tutorials online on coding in Lua. You can do Corona SDK, some tutorials on JavaScript, which will be a little bit harder, but then you'll still be able to do that. Thanks for commenting. So that's it for this week's Minute of Overpass. Now, if you're watching this on the iTunes podcast, please leave a review. And if you're watching this on YouTube, please comment like iClash did, or like the video, subscribe, all that kind of stuff. The same if you're watching this on LinkedIn or Facebook. So that's it for this week. Talk to you next week. Goodbye.